Okay, talking about intolerance, yet another example last night of the anti-Catholic bigotry of our ABC, the national broadcaster. I gave examples last night, but today, Dominic Perrottet became the new Premier of New South Wales, chosen overwhelmingly by colleagues to replace Gladys Berejiklian, who quit last Friday. But the ABC's Paul Barry last night was one more ABC journalist who couldn't get over Perrottet being Catholic.
Whoever becomes the next New South Wales Premier, likely to be Conservative Catholic Dominic Perrottet, will have a steep mountain to climb.
You think that's just an innocent descriptor? Well, I ask you. Have you ever heard the ABC in a news report use the descriptor, well, the Anglican Kevin Rudd, the Anglican Bill Shorten, the Uniting Church's Penny Wong? Nor do you hear the ABC keep referring to the Catholic Malcolm Turnbull, which shows what a dumb stereotype of a Catholic the ABC is pushing. That the real Catholics, or at least the ones we all have to watch out for, are conservatives, God's police, finger waggers, straighteners. And at his press conference today, Perrottet had reporters asking him, it was just incredible, what are you going to do about abortion? What are you going to do about euthanasia? What about your six kids? Who's going to look after them? And this one, do gays and lesbians have anything to fear from you? I mean, it was sick. I thought Perrottet answered that kind of badgering very well.
My religious views and my Christian faith is something I'm incredibly proud of, as many people across our state are. And that is something that is personal to me and personal to many people. And I think that's incredibly important. We live in a very diverse society. I think some of the criticism in relation to that diversity has been unfounded. And I'm proud to live, and I love our state, and I love the diversity and the multicultural backgrounds and the religious backgrounds. Diversity should be celebrated. It shouldn't be criticised. People should judge people on who they are and what they say, not based on some religious element.
It is so sad that that needs saying now in Australia. But enough. Who is Dominic Perrottet really? The former New South Wales Treasurer, now the youngest Premier ever in New South Wales. Just 39 years old. Well, today he announced his priority as Premier. It wasn't just infrastructure, we'll do that too, he said. And it wasn't just opening up the state from the lockdowns. It was pretty hot on that.
But it'll also be a family premier, focusing on how we can make life better for working families, living the liberal values of opportunity, aspiration and hard work.
Perrottet also said that the heart of his government will be in Western Sydney. Joining me is someone who actually knows Perrottet and counts him as a member of his organisation, John Roskam, head of the Free Market Institute of Public Affairs. John, thanks for joining me. What kind of man is Dominic Perrottet?
Dominic Perrottet is a man of strong belief, of strong values. He believes in freedom. You're talking about freedom of speech. He's spoken many times about the importance of freedom of speech. And Andrew, as you were saying, the reason the ABC was going after Dominic Perrottet was because he is proud of who he is, proud of his Christian background, proud of his family. He won't apologise. He's not a modern-day Christian that will swing to the left, that will swing to public opinion. And he is going to potentially be very attractive to mainstream Australians who do not share the values of the ABC. And exactly as Perrottet said, people should be judged on what they say and what they do, not their religion. And it's exciting that he is taking the Liberal Party to where the Liberal Party should be, to the homes of working Australians, working people in Sydney who don't necessarily vote Liberal now and who've had really no one to represent them. I think what Dominic Perrottet represents is something important, not just for New South Wales, but potentially all Australians.
It's so weird, you know, if a Catholic is of the left, like Christina Keneally or Malcolm Turnbull or something, it's suddenly not an issue. But if they're a conservative and Catholic, suddenly Catholic, it's really weird. Now, Perrottet said today, yet again, that while he may be against abortion and euthanasia, he will not be forcing his views on his party. MPs have a conscience vote on such issues, and he was very much for that. That said, how do you think his faith will influence him as a leader?
Well, it will influence him as Julia Gillard's atheism influenced her. Everyone is shaped by their background, by their religion, by their beliefs. And I think one of the things about people of faith as Christians or of any other religion or denomination is that people understand the importance of the individual, of families. I think Dominic Perrottet has argued strongly against continued lockdowns because he understands the devastation on young people. People of faith understand that we're not here for ourselves. We're not here for the next 5 minutes. We're here for the people around us, for the next generation and the generations that will come after that. And he's unapologetic about that. And we haven't had a leader, we haven't had a Liberal leader certainly like that for many years. I don't think we've had a Liberal leader, state or federal level certainly, that stands up and speaks to the values that the Liberal Party once used to believe in.
Well, a religion that apparently helps to underline his belief in freedom and families. How frightening is that for the ABC? You can imagine why they're in shock. Freedom and families, we can't have that. Now, his faith is one thing, his policies are another. Under Berejiklian, the Liberals in New South Wales have drifted to the left on social issues and various other things. Global warming, that's a big one. What difference do you think Perrottet will make?
Well, this is going to be a very big challenge, Andrew, because Dominic Perrottet believes in free markets, lower taxes, smaller government. He has proposed some very significant red tape reductions in New South Wales. He wants to change the stamp duty regime to bring down house prices. The question is, will the rest of his party allow him to do that? I don't think Matt Dean has been good for New South Wales. He hasn't been good for Australia. He has proposed policies that will further push up the price of energy and electricity and will hurt working families. And Dominic Perrottet is going to have to accommodate Matt Keane and the majority of the New South Wales Liberal Party in Parliament, which is of the left. This is going to be a big challenge. I think Dominic Perrottet has made a magnificent start so far, but tomorrow the hard work starts. And he's going to have as many opponents in his own party as he is going to have across the aisle.
John Roskam, thank you so much for your time.